two deals back-to-back took place between GSK and HUL. In one of the deals, which was an all-cash deal, HUL paid GSK a sum of 3,045 crore rupees for the acquisition, which helped itself to unlock the value in the balance sheet for its shareholders. While in the second deal, it was an all-equity deal, 18.46 crore equity shares were issued by HUL to GSK and which were later on sold in the secondary market as India's largest block deal till date. I'm sure that whatever I spoke for the last 20-25 seconds, you have understood nothing. And even if you feel that you have understood everything, I'll definitely tell you that you know nothing, Jon Snow. So if you really want to understand what I spoke about in the last few seconds, very much in detail, in the most simplified manner, check out the full video. Hi guys, CA Rachana Ranade here, and I welcome you all to a brand new video about GSK and HUL deal. Okay, believe me friends, this is a little bit tricky deal. So if you were to understand all the finer aspects of the deal, I request that you should pay 110% attention so that you can understand this detail very understand this video very much in detail. Okay, I'll try to simplify things to the best possible level. Okay, so let's first start with HUL. Okay, HUL is basically a subsidiary company of Unilever. Okay, Unilever is the holding company. It is Unilever PLC. Okay, in India, like we call limited. Outside India, in UK, they have to use the word, they have to use the suffix as PLC. Okay, so in India, how do we say Reliance Limited, Avenue Supermarts Limited? Okay, limited word is used as a suffix in India. Outside India, various suffixes will be used, like in UK, limited is also used and PLC is also used. Okay, so Unilever Limited is what is the holding company, parent company, and they have a subsidiary in India which is known as Hindustan Unilever Limited. Okay, this is a simple version for understanding the HUL pattern. So HUL is an Indian company, which is a subsidiary company, and holding company is a UK based company, Unilever PLC. Simple. Okay, holding company scenario, I hope clear. Now let us come to GSK. But GSK deal can be a little bit tricky. GSK structure can be a little bit tricky. So I'm trying to simplify it first. Let's take this example. Assume that A is a holding company and A holds 100% shares of B and 100% shares of C as well. Okay, so B and C become the fully owned subsidiaries of A. Okay, holding subsidiary, basic thing. Okay, if you don't know what is holding subsidiary, then I think you should refer my fundamental analysis lecture series in which I've explained all these terms very much in detail. But I'm presuming here that you know what is a holding subsidiary. So A is a holding company, B and C right now are its subsidiaries. Acha, now could it happen that B and C have also invested somewhere? Okay, so assume that B and C have also invested in another company D. Okay, now who are this A, B, C and D? Okay, now for D, what is the scenario? Let us understand. For D, who is B? For D, B is a holding company. For D, C is also a holding company. They are known as intermediate holding companies. But for D, A is also a holding company and A will be known as the ultimate holding company. So it's something like grandfather, father, son. Okay, most simplified format. I hope this, you got this. Okay, now if this is clear in your mind, now let us try to replace this with A is GSK PLC, which is the UK based company. Okay, so GSK, GlaxoSmithKline, which maybe some of you might have felt that it's an Indian company, but wait, GSK PLC is the main UK company. They have two subsidiaries. Which two subsidiaries? One is GSK PTE Singapore Limited. Okay, so now one subsidiary in Singapore, GSK PTE Singapore, and second one is Horlicks Limited. Oh my god, till date I'm sure everyone knew Horlicks as a health drink, but Horlicks is the name of the company, okay, which is a subsidiary of GSK PLC. Shock laga, right? So Horlicks Limited, by the way, this is also a UK based company. Horlicks is not an Indian company. Okay, so Horlicks Limited is a UK based company. Okay, now, okay, tell you, now step number three. Now what happens? Horlicks Limited UK holds some percentage shares. I'm going to tell you the exact percentage. In D, and GSKPT Singapore also holds some shares in D. And then who is this G? Who is this D? D is nothing but GSK, GlaxoSmithKline, CH, India Limited. Okay. Whew. First we understood the structure. Okay. So what has happened basically? This D is an Indian company which is listed on the Indian stock exchange, GSK CH Limited, and HUL, which is also the Indian company which is listed on the Indian stock exchange, but whose holding companies are both Firangi companies, both are in UK. Okay, so is this structure absolutely clear? I hope you have understood this absolutely in detail. Now that you have understood the entire structure of GSK and HUL, now let's move on with one of the deals that took. Okay, I'm just reading the actual headline for you. What is it given? HUL acquires Horlicks brand from GSK for 3045 crores. Okay, if you start reading this entire news line by line, then it can become a little bit tricky for you. So I'm trying to give you a very simplified version of that. Okay, so just try to understand this. I'll rub this from the screen so that you get a fair enough idea of actually what happened. Okay, now the deal, so two deals have taken place here. Okay, which two deals? The very first deal has taken place between the two companies. Which two companies? GSK UK and HUL UK. Okay, the original deal has taken place between these two companies. Okay, and what was the deal between these two companies? It is something like, I'm trying to give you a simplified version of this. It is something like HUL said that we are buying a right, please pay attention, we are buying a right to buy the Horlicks brand for our subsidiaries. It's tricky, please try to pay attention. Has HUL UK directly bought Horlicks brand? No. What have they bought? They have bought a right to buy. Right to buy what? Horlicks brand. And for whom? For their subsidiaries. So what does this indicate? It indicates that HUL, so in a simplified version, try to understand this. HUL might have told GSK that if any one of our subsidiaries wants to buy Horlicks distribution rights in their own country, they may buy it directly from you. So in our example, if HUL, Hindustan Unilever Limited, wants to buy the brand for the distribution purpose in India. So let us say HUL wants to sell Horlicks. Okay, I'm writing this for you. If HUL wants to sell Horlicks where in India, then they will have to buy the brand from whom? They have to buy directly from GSK UK. Okay, so what HUL does in this case, HUL exercises its option. Exercises its option to buy Horlicks. Okay, for those who are aware about F&O, they might have understood this is very much like a call option that I'm talking about. Okay, so what did HUL UK buy? One last time, try to focus. This is very much close to options. This is very much close to a call option. Okay, so those who always say on my channel, do a series on F&O, this is F&O, this is like call option, and something like an call option for you. Okay, last time, try to pay attention. Has HUL UK directly bought Horlicks as a brand? No, they have bought a right. They said that if any of our subsidiaries wants to buy Horlicks brand from GSK UK, for what purpose? For selling that brand in their own country, then let them buy it from you. Don't allow anyone else other than our subsidiaries to buy Horlicks brand from you. Okay. And that is very, very similar to a call option. So this is like HUL bought a call option for Horlicks, and HUL India. Okay, sorry. This is not HUL, this is Unilever. Extremely sorry. Okay, so the original company Unilever had just bought a right, and HUL India actually exercised the call option. Okay, I hope this is clear. Now, what happens in return? In this case, HUL exercised the right for that. How much did they pay? 3045 crore rupees to whom? Directly to GSK UK. Okay, but now wait. किसी के पेट में दर्द हो रहा है, someone is really getting hurt, and who is that? That is Unilever UK Limited. Why? Unilever UK is saying, hey HUL, you got this right to buy the brand of Horlicks because of us. Unilever is telling to its subsidiary, HUL, you got this brand to sell in India because of us, because we had bought the right to buy Horlicks. Okay, so don't you think Unilever is also going to demand something? And what is Unilever going to demand? Unilever is going to demand royalty. Okay, who will have to pay royalty to whom? Logically, who will have to pay royalty to whom? Obviously, Horlicks India will have to pay a royalty to Unilever UK. Okay, obviously, na? Because whatever sale Horlicks India will do, they'll have to pay a percentage of that to Unilever UK. I hope this is clear. And royalty, by the way, is to be paid at the rate of 1% of turnover. Okay, so assume that turnover of Horlicks becomes 1000 crores, then 10 crores straight away will have to be paid by HUL to its holding company Unilever UK Limited. Is the first deal clear? So that was about 3045 crores deal. 3045 crores all cash deal between whom and whom? Between HUL and GSK UK. My God, I tried to do this in a most simplified fashion, but still, if you feel you want to revise this, you can revise this one more time and then go to the next part of this video. Just to check our understanding, let's read this news which appeared in the newspaper. Okay, what did it say? Hindustan Unilever Limited, the country's biggest consumer goods firm, said that it has acquired Horlicks brand from whom? GSK PLC. Correct. HUL, the Indian company, bought Horlicks brand from GSK PLC for how much? 3045 crores. Correct. How did they acquire this? Because they exercised its option. See the same words. They exercised its option from the original agreement. Original agreement between whom and whom? Its parent, matlab holding company, whom? Unilever and GSK. Yes, we have understood this. Correct. Now, one more thing that they mentioned. As per the deal announced in December 2018, Horlicks brand owned by GSK PLC, okay, obviously it was owned by the parent company, was acquired by parent Unilever, and HUL would have to pay royalty. Who would have to pay royalty? HUL would have to pay royalty for its use in India. To whom? To Unilever. We discussed about this, and how much also we said? 1%. Now, HUL said that this latest deal for India has enabled the company to utilize cash on its balance sheet, create value for shareholders. This is the word I had used in the first part of the video, creating value for shareholders. Now, what does this mean? If a company has heavy cash balance, heavy cash and bank balance on its balance sheet, is it good or bad? Heavy, excessively high cash and bank balance. It's bad, excessively high balance. Simple reason being that the return that you are getting on this cash and bank balance is going to be very low. Now, instead of keeping this funds idle without giving best returns, this can be used to buy a good investment which can in turn give better returns to the company. Okay, so this idle cash, if it be in current account, what is the return? Zero. In current account, it's going to be zero. Instead of that, if they strike a very good deal like this Horlicks deal, then what will happen? Will their revenue increase? Yes. And that is why we say that some value will be created value for shareholders. It means nothing but the revenues will increase, the profit will increase. Yes. So I hope now this news, whatever appeared in exact words in media, now you have been able to digest it absolutely well. Okay. So if we go back to now, I hope this part is clear. Okay. So instead of again revising this, I had not talked about the shareholding pattern though. So this was the parent company, Horlicks Limited UK, GSK PT Singapore. I talked about this. Now in Indian company, okay, GSK Consumer Health in India, I did not mention about this shareholding, 43.16% and 29.29%. okay, who was ABCD? A was whom? A was GSK PLC, B was Horlicks. Okay, so A holds 100% in B, and A holds 100% in C is what we had talked about, and B and C hold percentage shares in D. How much I had not told you? It was 43.16% and 29.29% stake in GSK. Okay, now question is, why did they do all these things? GSK, does it have a very good product portfolio? What products does GSK have? Why HUL was behind GSK? Now, if you actually understand the brands, then you will understand what amazing brands GSK has. The brand portfolio of GSK looks something like this. Crocin, Iodex, Eno, Sensodyne. This part of the portfolio is other than nutritional portfolio. OTC is over the counter. Okay, for those who don't know what is over the counter, these could be medicines which are sold without any prescription. Okay, that is OTC medicines. Okay, so OTC way they have a very good portfolio like Crocin and even oral OHC is oral healthcare. They have Sensodyne, but this is an important part which is nutrition based part. Health drinks is what we call Horlicks, Boost, Maltova, Viva. All these are the brands of GSK. Okay. Now, what brands HUL have? Oh my God, so many. But we'll concentrate on the drinks part. It is Brew, it is Lipton, it is Taj Mahal Brooke Bond, okay, Nor Soup, and Taza, and of course, in ice cream, it is Quality Walls, okay. Okay. Other brands also in personal, like I'm sure you all have heard about these brands. Ponds, Lakme, Fair and Lovely, Clinic Plus. Oh my God, I'm feeling like I'm doing an advertisement for HUL only. Okay, so in short, HUL has a very big product portfolio. Now with GSK's portfolio also with them, I feel they have a very rich product portfolio which can in turn bring better sales for the company, right? Now we will talk about advantages which have occurred to HUL, but in the immediate next section of the video. Now let's talk about why HUL wanted to buy GSK. Were there any advantages for HUL or not? So there are some advantages. I've just taken top three advantages. Okay, there are many, but we'll discuss only three. So the very first advantage is that HUL's distribution, which is nearly three times of GSK consumer, would help deeper penetration of GSK consumer products. Okay, I feel for any consumer related company, consumer goods related company, distribution plays a very, very important role. Better the distribution, they can reach out to a bigger population and thereby the sales can increase. Okay, so for example, if Boost or Horlicks was reaching only to one household earlier, now they can potentially reach three households. So there is a potential increase in the turnover of the business as well. Okay, now it says that merger will make HUL's food and refreshment business 1.6 times larger and will give it a strong nutrition brand. So why this word strong nutrition brand is important? Because in HUL's product portfolio, what we talked about right now, they didn't have any health drink in their portfolio. Okay, they had Lipton, they had a Brew, but all these are normal drinks. Okay, they are not health drinks. So I think this is a very important addition to HUL's portfolio, which according to experts, they feel that 1.6 times larger will be the portfolio for HUL. And Credit Suisse, which is of course a very well-known investment banker, they said that they have raised the financial year 21 earnings estimates by 6.5%. So what they feel in simple words, that for financial year 20, in simple interpretation, if HUL's earning revenue is 100, Credit Suisse, one of the very famous research firms, feels that for financial year 21, their revenue can be 106.5. okay, why this increase in revenue mainly will be because of this merger. Advantages, simple and clear. Now the first part of the deal is clear, advantages are also clear. Now let's move on to the second deal which happened between GSK and HUL. I hope some space is left in your mind for absorption. Okay, I feel that yes, but you should try to push up yourself and try to understand this second deal, because this is the one because of which Do Dil Ek Jaan is what has happened. What is Do Dil Ek Jaan? Originally, it was Do Dil, HUL, Hindustan Unilever Limited, a separate company. GSK, CH, India Limited. Okay. Both Indian companies were totally different companies. And now what has happened? Do Dil got converted into Ek Jaan. So what happened is that this company completely got absorbed into HUL as one jaan. Okay, so now GSK doesn't exist only. Where has it gone? It has merged completely into HUL. Okay, now who will be crying? Who will be crying? Sun raha hai na tu, ro rahe hai ye. Who is crying? Of course, the shareholders of GSK are crying. Shareholders of GSK will say that if the company ceases to exist, then we are shareholders of whom? Okay, so don't you think that if this company was to be sold off entirely to some other company, the permission of the shareholders of GSK would be required? Okay, so a proper resolution is passed and then this merger takes place. Okay, so now what happens that this entire business of GSK India was sold off to HUL. So if entire business, all assets, all liabilities are given to HUL, of course, don't you think HUL will give something in return? Okay, what can HUL give to the shareholders of GSK? What will they give? Possibility number one, they can give cash. Possibility number two, they can give shares of HUL. Okay, so they'll have to give something in return, something in consideration. What was the consideration in this case? Like in the Horlicks case, it was all cash deal. That is why I said 3045 crores was given as in return. Here, cash is not given. Here, equity shares are given. Now, what has been given? Let's understand. On 21st April 2020, when HUL completed its buying for GSK, so actually 2nd April, if I'm not mistaken, the entire deal was complete. But this is the date when the company allotted how many shares? 18,46,23,812 shares. Oh my god, 18.46 crore shares. This is what again I told in the first part of the video. To whom? To the shareholders who were holding the shares of GlaxoSmithKline Consumer Health. That is why I say CH, Consumer Healthcare Limited, as on the record date. Okay. Now, again, one more question to you. Okay. So, HUL gave 18.46 crore shares to whom? To the shareholders of GSK. Now you have to tell me, who are the shareholders of GSK? Who are the shareholders? You remember that diagram? Who are the shareholders? B and C. And who are they? Horlicks Limited and GSK PTE Singapore. Yes, you're getting it right. So they got the shares. Okay. But finally, these two companies are owned by whom? They're owned by the main holding company, and which is what? GSK PLC. Yes. So finally, what happened is that HUL has sold off all its shares. Has given in return. थोड़ा भावुक हो गई मैं. They have given 18.46 crore shares to whom? Ultimately to GSK UK company. Okay. So I hope this is clear till here. Now you will be wondering, from where did I understand that all these things happened and how many shares were issued and in what ratio they were issued and how did I come to know about this? So if you want to understand this, I'm going to give you a very, very amazing input right now. If you want to know very much in detail about any deal, okay, so the best website that you can see here is nscindia.com website. Okay, I'm going to the original website of NSC India, the original website. Okay. Okay. When this website appears, just go to the corporate section. Okay. Very important, friends. Go to the corporate section, and in corporate section, here you can see scheme of arrangement. Okay. When you click scheme of arrangement, you will understand about all the mergers and acquisitions which have taken place till date. Okay. Such a big list. See, you will find this big list of all the acquisitions and mergers which have taken place. Okay, so let me just scroll down. Jan May, who was it? It's 10th Jan. No, okay, I'll just do Control F. Glaxo, yes. See, this is the scheme of amalgamation between GlaxoSmithKline Consumer Healthcare Limited and HUL. I just have to click here, and a big zip file will start downloading. Okay, so this download is now complete, and let me take you to what appears on the screen. You have so many reports which come up on the screen, and in this you will find a lot of information. If you are really interested in this, I think you should, at least for one deal, try to go dig down deep as to what has happened. And these are the documents, because everyone says, ma'am, from where do you do the research? Please tell us. These are the documents from which we have done a lot of research. Okay, we have tried our level best to go into each and every document and understand what happened in the deal. Okay, so now I'll take you back to what had happened. So this is how the information was collected. Okay, so how many shares were allotted? 18.46 crore shares were allotted to GSK. Okay, now as I mentioned, finally this is the structure, and HUL has given the shares. Okay, now understand who is the holding company. It's of course Horlicks, Glaxo. This is 43.16, this is 29.29. of course this doesn't total up to 100, so what about others? Other public shareholding is 27.55. okay, simple till here. Okay, so there were three major category of shareholders, I can say. One was Horlicks, one was GlaxoSmith, and others. Okay, so this was the original holding in what? Original holding in GSK. okay, how many shares did each and every shareholder own? So here I have given number of shares. Okay, 1,81,52,243 shares were held by Horlicks, 1,23,19,749 shares were held by GlaxoSmithKline, and so on and so forth. Okay, now if they held so much shares of GSK, and now GSK is sold off, question is how much shares did HUL give to them? HUL allotted these many shares in return. Okay, so the ratio comes out to 1:4.39. okay, in simple words, for every single share of GSK that any shareholder held in GSK, he would now get 4.39 shares in HUL. okay, and so if you just take it on your calculator, this 1,81,52,243 into 4.39, what you will get is this number of shares. Okay, so I hope now you have understood that these shares were allotted to whom? To the shareholders of GSK. Now question is, what happened with the shares? Okay, Horlicks Limited got these shares, itne shares, 7,96,00,000 in HUL. GlaxoSmithKline also got these many shares in HUL. So these two have got shares of whom? HUL. But who is saying now? GSK PLC saying, but you are my 100% subsidiary. So finally who got it? Finally GSK PLC only got it. What GSK PLC did with the shares is they sold off all the shares. Okay, they sold off all the shares. This is what I've given in my next slide. They sold 13,37,72,044. Where did this 13 crore shares come from? This is the addition of these two. Okay, 13,37,72,044 shares were sold by GlaxoSmithKline PTE were on the stock market, and this was the largest block deal which took place on the Indian stock exchange. Oh my god, I hope you have understood this. This was, believe me, one of the trickiest deals for you to understand. I have not taken any merger and acquisition lecture till date on my YouTube channel, but I feel you should really watch this one more time so that you get a proper feel of this. I hope this will properly absorb in you as to exactly what happened. Oof, I hope you have understood all the aspects of this video. This was a little bit tricky one. I had to summarize almost 3 days research of me and my team into a less than 25 minutes video, hopefully, on the YouTube channel. I tried to summarize it. I tried to condense it in the most simplified format. But I also wanted to share one very good news with you all. Our channel has crossed 5,000 paid members on YouTube. And how to become my member on YouTube channel is that you just have to click the join button, which you can see on my homepage. So just a giveaway from my side for my paid members, whether you are in the student category or whether you are in the investor or the pro investor category, I'm coming out with a separate video, a special video, which is about the valuation part of this same video, because everyone wants to know that how is the valuation done, how is the ratio decided. So like that 4.39 is to 1, how was that ratio decided? That is a part of the valuation aspect. So for all the paid members, it is a small thank you from my side, wherein I'm going to explain how that ratio of 4.39 is to 1 was decided. So if you are still not a member of my channel, do consider joining my memberships, because always remember that investment in knowledge gives you the best returns. Okay, so that's it from my side for the day, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this one. Jai Hind and bye bye.